Hey, boys and girls, it's Friday. You know what that means. It's time to head out for a fish sandwich. Today we're going to Long John Silver's. See where they stack up in the best fast food fish sandwich series. All right, let's get to it.
Yeah, I just want the, is there a fish sandwich?
Just the sandwich by itself or the combo?
I'll do the combo.
Okay, well, one side I want to drink for both.
Fries and, do you have cherry Pepsi?
Yeah, we have cherry Pepsi.
Cherry Pepsi. Fries and cherry Pepsi.
Fries and cherry Pepsi?
Yep.
All right. So I managed to land a Long John Silver's fish sandwich. All right. Welcome. I'm Sean with Food Supremacy. If you're here for the first time, glad to have you aboard. If you've been here before, welcome back. As stated earlier, I went out to land a Long John Silver's fish sandwich. The reason I made sure to document the process was I wasn't sure they had a fish sandwich. Sounds crazy, right? But I feel like maybe they've had it for years and I just didn't know. But I feel like all these fast food restaurants that are just now getting sandwiches, it's a crazy development to me. Shouldn't they always have had sandwiches, like the chicken sandwiches? But I digress. I landed the fish sandwich, came with a combo basket, which come with fries and a small cherry Pepsi, as you may or may not have saw me order already. And it came to $6.73 with tax. Not bad. Looks like your average fish sandwich. One thing I will say about, oh wow, lots of pickles. How about that? Pretty cool. Peace, fella. I will say the Long John Silver's fries travel the worst. I have an air fryer. I probably should use that to heat them up, but I'm committed. Before I get to the meat and potatoes of this video, I want to talk a little bit about Long John Silver's. I know I mentioned in a previous video that my brother is a big fan of Popeyes. Well, he's also a big fan of Long John's. Noticing a trend here. Old bro is into the fried goods. Nothing wrong with that. You know, we're here for a good time, not a long time. One thing I like to do at Long John's is dip my fries in tartar sauce. Might be the whitest thing you'll hear of the day, but hey, I'm into it. I don't do it anywhere else. Like, I don't sit around my house dipping my fries in mayo or tartar sauce. But regardless, that's something I do when I go to Long John's. But like I said about my brother, he's a big Long John Silver's fan. And you might think, well, a lot of people liked Long John Silver's. Well, we used to actually go there for his birthday. There's actually a family picture where we were there, me, him, my mom, and dad. My mom and I opted for the Long John Silver's captain style hat. If I can find a picture of that, I'll throw it up and we'll have a good laugh. There's always good times at Long John's. Things they have at Long John's that I always take advantage of. These are like Long John Silver's hacks, if you will. They have that Heinz malt vinegar. Stuff is no joke. I've been looking for it in the store. I haven't been able to find it. I know they have it. I just looked in the wrong place probably. The Heinz malt vinegar. Also, they have above average hot sauce. The Long John Silver's, the kind of hot sauce they carry is very good. I always like to bring up a memory, an old memory of the food that I'm eating, the restaurant that I went to get the food from. There was a Long John Silver's in the food court at the mall. If you were low on money, you know, I love a food hack for people that are low on money. You could get a dozen hash browns for a dollar. Now, you know, not the best option, but when you have a buck, you're not going to find anything to fill you up more than those 12 hash browns. Well, maybe the Dollar Whopper that's available on Wednesdays. If you missed that video, I'll throw a link up to it and you can check that out. But I don't know if they still offer that at Long John's. I'm going to be honest. These days, Long John's is not in my rotation. I don't go to Long John's very often. Once in a great while. I mean, you know, there's obviously a reason for that. Long John's, you know, tough business. If you eat it, you know, you got to have the rest of your day mapped out. You got to have flexibility for the rest of your day if you're going to eat Long John's, because things can go south. You know, this is a high amount of grease. Another thing, I remember I used to get those combo baskets at Long John's. They were like $8. Don't even come with a drink. So with a drink, it'd be like $10. And this was a few years back. I'm sure they still had them. I think they were made for maybe two people, maybe three people, but I would get one for myself. They were crazy. It'd be like three pieces of fish, three pieces of chicken, two shrimp, fries, slaw, and a couple hush puppies. It's pretty wild. That's the kind of things I like, though. The more the merrier. All right. If the impression you've got already, not huge expectations for this fish sandwich. We'll see, though. I'm going in with an open mind, I swear. One thing they did really well, lots of pickles, man. I figured, why not? You know, you might say, what if someone doesn't like pickles? They put a lot of pickles on it. Well, those of you that don't like pickles, you have two options. One, pick them off. Two, say no pickles. So this is the rest of us that like pickles, pile them on, man. The more the merrier. Not, you know, about what I expected. Not the best. I will say that so far out of what I have, this will be the lowest score. I just feel like that Long John's fish, you know, it's really greasy, obviously, like all fish, but it's not great. You know, it's better as a standalone, not on a fish sandwich. It's not, you know, it needs to be bigger, crunchier, better to be on a fish sandwich. So that said, I'm going to give this one a 5-4 on the fish sandwich review. That puts it in last place out of four. The leader at this point is still Popeyes. Gonna be hard to beat Popeyes. So what, as far as what do I have left? Which fish sandwiches do I have left? I have Dairy Queen, Burger King, Wendy's. I think that's all the, if Hardee's has one. Running out of Fridays. I mean, I don't know if I have more Fridays left than I do fish sandwiches I'm going to try. Either way, I might go get another one later today. I might do the Dairy Queen one. I think I saw something where it's like $2. But yeah, if I'm leaving anything off, let me know. I don't think I am. I mean, obviously some of these are not in my area. I'm not going to drive across the country to get a specific one. All right, and I'm going to conclude the latest episode of the Best Fast Food Fish Sandwich Series. Like I said, this one was Long John Silver's. And if you have any one that you think I should try, or you know, you have any recommendations, obviously let me know in the comments. Again, I'm Sean with Food Supremacy, and thanks for checking out my video.